Yo, what up, what's poppin'? It's me, Josh Otusanya, here again, and in this video, we're gonna talk about how to be single. How to be single. Woo! You're recently single, you've been single, you're trying to find out how to be happier, how to live your life, and how to get the best out of it, because being single is not a bad thing. This video is for you. Being single is dope if you're doing it right. You can learn a lot, you can grow a lot, and you can really take advantage of this time period for you to become a better person. Now, first off, you need to immerse yourself in your life's purpose, and if you don't have one, you gotta find one. Remember what helped me the most when I got out of my most serious relationship ever? It was like a few years. I was just immersing myself in my life's purpose. All the projects and things I was working on, all the comedy stuff I was doing, all my dreams and goals and ambitions, I really immersed myself in that and started to find my potential. I really started to spread my wings. I made a conscious effort to just invest in my future. That's what you need to do. Invest in your future.
Invest in your future.
Now, if you have no clue what your purpose is, you have to start with what are your hobbies? You know, what do you like to do? What do you naturally gravitate towards? No matter how nuanced you think your hobbies or interests are, we're in an age where with social media, you can make a career basically out of anything. If you really love basket weaving and you want to have a basket weaving business, you can literally pick up a camera, start a blog, start something, and start your own basket weaving business and have clients and customers all over the place. Next, self-development. This is so important. You have to spend this time investing in bettering yourself, because then your relationships over time should get better and better and better, because you should be in between relationships becoming a better person while at the same time getting a better sense of what you want and what you're looking for so that you choose better partners. Don't be that person if you recently got out of a relationship, whether it was your fault or all the other person's fault. Don't come out of a relationship blaming everything on the other person and acting like you are perfect. Even if the other person was like 99.99% wrong, there's still something you could have done better. So you gotta look back and reflect and be like, yo, what did I not do well? What were some of my weaknesses and how can I improve upon them? Like, I'll open up to you guys. I used to be insanely jealous. You are mine. It's like super jealous, possessive, stuff like that. I used to be very jealous. So over time, I just worked on finding ways to just not be jealous. Now, I took some time, I worked on it, I made conscious efforts to like know how to distance myself, and I also reframed my thinking. I realized that in relationships, the person you're with, you don't own that person. They're their own person. You're two individuals choosing to live this life together. Now, in every romantic relationship, fling, whatever you want to call it, that I've had after that, I've never been jealous like that anymore because I worked on it. Adding on to that, for real, address your weaknesses, pick up self-development books. And also, to add on to that, all these cool books you're reading, YouTube videos you're watching, all this information you're filling in your head, you got to make sure you actually go out and practice those things, put them into practice. That's how you get better. So I'll tell you this, look, I've been in situations where I've been trying to motivate myself and be just a more productive person, a less lazy person, but I just watch hours of YouTube videos back to back to back on like, yo, you gotta believe in yourself. You gotta believe. You're amazing. You gotta work hard. And I'm just like, oh, I'm so pumped up. But I'm really just laying in my bed still being lazy. So you actually gotta get up and make something happen. Next, I think this is insanely important. Don't make it your life's mission to find a partner. Yo, you gotta stop that, because if anything, you're just gonna get in your own way. The funny thing is, when you want something bad enough, you could actually prevent it from happening. It's like if you really, really, really wanted to get into an exclusive party. You just got into the exclusive party. This is gonna be a weird example. You finally get into this exclusive party, and you're so afraid of losing or getting kicked out of this exclusive party that you start acting irrationally. You might be like, yo, I don't wanna get kicked out of this party. I do not wanna get kicked out of this party. I do not want to get kicked out of this party. And you keep screaming louder and louder because you're freaking out. You don't want to get kicked out of the party. And eventually you're screaming so loud, some dude's like,
hey man, I'm a bouncer and I'm gonna have to kick you out of this party.
So if you're putting too much pressure on relationships to happen, look, you might be on dates, putting too much pressure on the person you're on a date with. You might be trying to mold them. You might have too long of a checklist. Look, relax, chill. Don't make it your life's mission. Next point, huge point, enjoy yourself. Enjoy yourself while you're single. Just, oh my goodness, just enjoy the hell out of life. This is the only life you got to live. And enjoying yourself means different things to different people. So that could mean going out on a lot of dates, meeting a lot of people, having a lot of flings. My name's Jim and I swipe right on everything. It could mean traveling. It could mean working towards your future. It's up to you. Last point that I'll say is try to take yourself out on a date. This is something that I actually started doing recently. I thought it was weird, but I had some friends say that they've done it before, and it's actually pretty nice. It's pretty pleasant, if I do say so myself. This is what I want you to do. Put some time in her calendar to do this, all right? Pick a movie that you really wanna see. Go out and see it by yourself. Sit there, enjoy the movie. Then after the movie, go out to a restaurant that you really like or that has the food that you really enjoy and treat yourself to an amazing meal.
Wow, this is a really nice restaurant.
Wow, it really is. Thank you so much for taking me out, myself. In the comments down below, let me know what you think. Do you prefer being single or in a relationship? Thank you so much for watching. For more videos, click over here.
Click it, click it, click.
So the other day, one of my friends, she deleted Instagram, and as a fellow millennial, I was like,
what are you doing?
And so the other day when I came back home, I wanted to get some writing done, but first I sat down on my bed, pulled out my phone, checked Facebook, and started scrolling.